to hear what the brother says himself. What is the claim?
I am saying that the Pyramid of Khufu was built for Khufu. That's what I'm saying.
Official debate Monday, Uncle West. Show up,
hey, bro.
If you get it,
listen.
How much time do we get? Because I want to give them all my time. You get three.
No, it's unprecedented.
You get three rounds, and y'all can do 10.
I don't want three rounds.
He doesn't want three rounds.
If you can end it in the first round,
listen. I'm gonna give him. Listen, if it's three rounds, I'll take my first round and defer the rest of all my time to him to try to get past what I'm gonna put down.
You don't show up, you know I'm gonna hunt you down.
You ain't gonna hunt me down. Okay, hold on, everybody. Let's get it official. Brother says he only needs 6 minutes to present a document. That's what he said?
Right. 10. Now, I won't take the 10. I want my first round, my 10 minutes.
Okay, you say we get 10.
I want 10. Because I want to read it slow and I want to crack some jokes in the middle of the words I'm reading. I want to do all that. You know, that's how I want to do it. I want to crack jokes, have fun. And I'm not even going to read the document to the day of. You're out of here, son. You're done. I'm going to show you what the professionals do.
Wow. Hey, you know you're underestimating this guy, huh?
I'm not underestimating him. I'm not underestimating him. Underestimated person, but I know he's not going to have no primaries. You support him. He's not going to have not one. I'm going to be the only one with a primary in this conversation.
Damn. All right, go ahead, champ. Speak on it.
Okay, good. Okay, so we've established that he wants one round, and that's it. He's going to bring a primary source. What's that?
Yep, I'm bringing one source for 10 minutes, and it's going to be a primary source.
He's going to read it slow, and he's going to crack jokes and read it slowly.
Yes, that's what I'm going to do.
That sounds great. All
right. Yep.
I think the help discussion, is that okay with you, brother? I changed my mind. Kind of, you know, can y'all hear me? Yeah, we heard you. That's good. Okay, you want three? Yep, just like you. 15 minutes apiece. Yep, just like that. Okay, you want three? And I think the help, the community, we should have a discussion after the second, third round, but I realize now this is definitely a teaching moment for us to really give the people to understand. I think I really want to do that. Okay.
Yeah, that's how usually Uncle talks shit. Okay, I was definitely talking shit. Uncle West officially wants all of his round. Teaching moment. He was trash talking.
I was talking shit. And I realized that I'm gonna be on my round. I'm round. and I like good dude, yo. You're good dude. So I'm gonna have to change my tone because I'm gonna look stupid. If I keep acting the way I'm acting, I'm gonna look stupid.
I cannot let you
have that weapon.
Shalom,
brother. I'll scream when you calm as a motherfucker. I can't do it. I changed my mind.
See, he believed that the guys in Egypt, Kemet, was real as well. Would you debate him on that?
Who?
The champ.
Who was real?
All of them.
Let's start off with the Pyramid of Khufu, yo. Who built the Pyramid of Khufu, champ?
We said the Pyramid of Giza. We're not talking about. We said, listen, you just understand
three of them on the Giza plateau, yo. What you talking about?
That's
talking
about the Giza one. Yes, that's the Pyramid of Giza. The Great Pyramid. That's what we're talking about.
That's Khufu's pyramid.
That's the Khufu's pyramid.
All right. Okay, go ahead.
Hey, man, listen. What you going to do, okay, Chad?
Okay, good. So your stance is that the Pyramid of Khufu was built, the Pyramid of Giza, the largest pyramid, was built during Khufu's time? That's your stance?
It's my stance.
Your stance is that the Pyramid of Khufu was built, the Pyramid of Giza, the largest pyramid, was built during Khufu's time? That's your stance?
It's my stance. Oh. It's going to take me, I only need 5 minutes. That's all I want is 5 minutes.
Okay.
That's it. I'm going to give you the rest of my time. Make it 6 minutes. I'm going to bring one document that's going to finish you off and you're done. And it's going to be a better lecture. You're out of there, son. Now.
Shame you open up your ears just a little late as I explain. You just another nigga lane slang.
What? You get three. No, it's unprecedented. You get three rounds. And y'all can do two. Y'all
I don't want three rounds.
He doesn't want three rounds.
If you can get in the first round, then hey. Listen, I'm going to give them. Listen, if it's three rounds, I'll take my first round and defer the rest of all my time to him to try to get past when I'm going to put that. I'm going to say it again. Three rounds, right? I'ma take 10 minutes and finish them all. You gonna be a checkmate, cause it's customary. You will be a checkmate. Let's see. You see the Mo-Pi? See why it's all the Mo-Pi don't wanna hear this shit.
A shame you open up your ears just a little late as I explain. You just another nigga laying slain.
Established. We just have to establish some things that Khufu is finding a site, the site of Giza. And when he finds the site of Giza, he finds a temple of Isis north of the house of Osiris. It's called the house of Saqqar. We just read directly from the Egyptians that Saqqar is Osiris's name. He got that name when he said to Aset, Isis and Nephthys, his wives, he said, come to me, come to me. And the term for come to me is Seker. So thus Osiris' name got turned to Seker in the story, and thus that temple, or that pyramid, is actually Seker. Khufu is not even in the picture yet. Khufu is finding this. Okay? Now we're going to get into the impossibility of why this could not be built by Khufu's people. Okay? Let's get into the impossibility. Here are the available tools that are found in Khufu's time period. Okay? Everybody can see this? These are the tools supposedly used to cut 80-ton stones and get them, remember, 481 feet in the air. This is what Khufu had accessible to him. In less than 40 seconds, being we only have 5 minutes to get them 600 miles away. We have to understand that the quarry stones to build the pyramid, most of the large ones came from 600 miles away. They have to precision cut them, set them in place. We're going to see Mark Leonard, 30-plus years top archaeologist, demonstrate to see how long it would take to cut these tools. So here are, in archaeology, we're in the museum, these are the available tools that Khufu had. These bronze pickaxes and these stones here. These are the tools found that Khufu had. So Khufu and his men built these pyramids. This brother has to show how do you use these tools to build the Great Pyramid of Giza, made of over 2.3 million stones standing at 481 feet. Now we're going to look at the demonstration of how long it took. Because remember, the calculation of moving 2.3 million stones, they would have to be moved every 5 minutes. Now, we're going to get into the video of them trying to demonstrate this. This is the video with using the tools. This is the tools. Here we go.
Turn it up, champ.
What?
Turn it up a little bit.
Oh, turn it up. Yeah. That's the loudest.
Okay, that's cool. We see him working. Go ahead.
Later, using the available tools, okay? That's the available tools that Khufu and his men had, and we're proposing that they use that. So here we go. These chisels, only a few dozen strikes per chisel. So not only do they have to use up the chisel, but one chisel only does a few dozen strikes. Then they have to reheat and remold, and it takes days to chisel, days. Remember, we have 5 minutes to move this block in the pyramid, according to the mathematics of Khufu ruling for 20 years. Moving 2.3 million stones 481 feet in the air. It took hours and they barely made a dent. But here is what they want us to believe. The volume about 2.5 million cubic meters. The pyramid in 20 years meant placing 800 ton stone blocks, one every day. This would mean, this, in addition, since it comprised of 2.3 million blocks constructed in 20 years required the relocation and installation on average of over 12 blocks every hour, day, and night, which means one block every 5 minutes. Here, 12 blocks, we'll do the mathematics. 12 blocks in an hour, one block every 5 minutes. It would have included the time to present for us on screen the tools that were used dating back to Pharaoh's Khufu time that could cut the stones of the pyramids in the precise mathematical cuts that the granite stones are in. Can you just post on the screen for us what tools they were? I don't want your theory or words. I'm gonna give you time to post to put the tool on the screen. Can you do that first, please? That's my question.
I'm gonna show you what you just did as I answer your question. You'll hear the comedic brother say, well, we can't find a tomb of, say, Moses, or a tomb of this person, that person. So that means they didn't exist. Well, there's a lot of tombs you can't find, but that still doesn't mean it doesn't exist. So just because they haven't found the tools doesn't mean that they can't do it. The proof is in the damn pudding. So no, they haven't found the tools that they use specifically on the pyramids. So what? That's part of archaeology. So that's not, that does not mean that they didn't do it because they haven't found the tools yet. So let's just say as of 2020, they haven't found the tools. But what we do know is, as they showed, I showed the progression to get to that point of being that you get. That's what I did show. Okay? Now, there wasn't a discrepancy in the stone. I showed that the quarry was right there where they got those massive stones from. Okay? And I showed you that the other stone used to case the joint was way downstream. That's what I
do.
Go ahead, next question, please, sir.
All right. Thank you so much for your answer. So we've established that there has been not been found. So first, we've established that they actually did find the tools. It's not like they didn't. It's not like they did not find the tools. They found the tools, but the tools are not adequate enough to do the work that you're claiming.
Next question, Jeff.
Next question. Did we prove in the video that the copper tools, just yes or no, that the copper tools at Khufu's disposal were insufficient to cut the granite stone? Did we not show that in the video? Just a yes or no. That they couldn't cut the granite stone. Not the saw, but the granite stone that they tried to chip with the chisel. Did we show in the video that it was insufficient? Oh, am I still on? Can you guys still see me? Yes or no, did I show in the video?
10 seconds, the witness revolutionary toothbrush.
Somebody, you guys still hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. Did I show in the video that the tools that they used to cut the granite, that were available to the Egyptians at the time, the Kemetim, could not even chip the granite stone. Did you see that in the video? Just yes or no?
Nope. What I will do is, since you're so smart, this is what I will do. Since you so want to know how they did it, right? That's your whole thing. That's your basic question. How they do it?
Answering another question. I only asked yes or no.
No, you can't tell me yes or no. You asked me, did they had a tool to do it? Did you?
No. I didn't ask that. In the video that I showed using the tools, they did not show that those tools could not even cut through the granite. Yes or no?
No, the tools actually showed them cutting through the granite. Yeah, I seen him, Diamond. You didn't see that?
No, the saw cut through the granite and took days. The tool that they were using.
You don't know what it took because you said that.
Yeah, okay. okay, all right. So, what tool did they use that you can show a primary source of the Kemetian sand themselves? What tools did they use to move the stones that were several tons, some of them up to 80 tons, 481 feet in the air? What tool was that called that they used, sir? What was the name of that tool, or where can we find that tool? Not the cutting, just the one they used to lift it up in the air.
So hold on, let me give it a whole time. First, I want to show you cutting stone. Let me show you the possibility of cutting stone, and then we can get into the moving of it.
Granite stone.
So y'all, JJ, you see my screen, right?
Hold on for a second. Go ahead.
Oh, this video.
You show you cutting stone, how you get the possibility. The basic hand is important. Let's see.
Oh, my God.
Hey, I
mute
your mic.
I'm sorry. I apologize.
Sorry.
My mic
shows. Alright, so clearly in this video, it's clear how you cut stone. Alright? Okay? So there are many different ways they could have did it. Here you go again. Stone cutters. These are your first masons, basically. So we know they had chisels, and we know they had hammers. We absolutely know that.
They're using the same tools. Oh my God. Come here. This video, look at this flashback. Look at this. This is how they made the precision cuts. Did you get 30 seconds to answer, or are we still on?
That's it. No, I'm done. I'm good.
Okay.
I wanted to show you the possibility.
Okay. 30 seconds. Okay, great.
Yeah, sorry. My fault. I stepped off. My fault. Yeah.
Okay, great. Sir, the video
and
that
for
you.
The record, and for the record, I'm going to throw you a source, bro.
The video that you showed, those sledgehammers that they were using, that is the archaeological hammer that Khufu had, yes or no?
No, I'm saying that we know they had mallets, and we know. Okay. We know they had the chisels. We do know that.
I don't think you heard my question.
First of all, okay, watch this. We know that these are the first masons and stone cutters. So we know they were able to cut stone. You tripping on that. That's not even up for debate if they could cut stone or not. We know they was the first mason are in Africa. They belong to the stone cutting guild. They cut stone. They cut obelisks. What about the large obelisks? Are you saying
they're not your turn to ask questions? He's taking over 30 seconds.
I'm showing you how they cut Stone. The Alice's are the proof that they could cut Stone, bro. Big sir, giant again,
sir, is the tools in the video that you shown, the tools that Pharaoh Khufu had access to, yes or no? Those big sledgehammers.
I'm showing you how Stone cut
yes or no.
No, they didn't have those particular tools, but they definitely okay. had mallets and chisels. And they cut the Alice's. You're going to try to tell the audience that they did cut giant obelisks?
So the answer, thank you.
The answer is no.
The video that you showed did not represent the technology that Pharaoh Khufu had.
The video shows that stone cutters, without cutting the way you thought they could cut stones. That's an ancient cutting technique there, bro. So I'm not going to argue you down. You know they cut large obelisks, perfectly cut obelisks. You know it, and I know it. And they move those big, giant obelisks. You know it, and I know it. So cutting stone and moving stone has never been impossible for those ancient engineers. Okay?
That's a no. That video completely misrepresents the technology accessible in Pharaoh Khufu's time. Yes, they could definitely sledgehammer stones in 2020, yes, but the tools that you showed is not the art. My question was, can you show the archaeological tools that Khufu and his men had access to? Not a video from 1995.
Okay,
the time is up. It's 30 seconds, and you've taken like 4 minutes.
Time up?
Yes, it is.
All right.